as always, that you are tuning in to Children's Ministry. I know that this time is a special time for me. I pray that it's a special time for you, that God knows you, He has a word for you, and that He's ministering to you during this time, just specifically to you, Faith Kids. So we're going to do what we do always. Let's get your Bibles, get your phones, your tablets, those things where you have the Bible on, and we're going to get ready to get into God's word for today. Father, we just come thanking you for this day. We thank you, God, for your word. God is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We thank you that we, God, are led through your word, oh Father. We thank you, your Holy Spirit, lead, guide, and direct us in all that we are to do, Father. And we pray that as we receive your word on today, God, that you will give us revelational truth, God, on what it is that we're to know in your word on today and how we are to apply it to our lives, Father God, that we will be pleasing unto you to every good work, Father. In your Son, Jesus' name, we pray. All right, Faith Kids, we have a lot of scripture on today to go through, but I know you can do it. You can handle it, Faith Kids. You can go through the scriptures with me on today. Of course, we're going to begin with your memory verse for this week. Faith Kids, read your memory verse throughout the week. It's important that we meditate upon the word of God. And he says that when we meditate upon his word, then he will make our way prosperous and we shall have good success. So take it not lightly that you're reading the word every single day, Faith Kids. So your memory verse for this week is John. Let's go to that Old New Testament, the book of John, verse 14. And 27. And we'll read that. I'm, of course, reading from the New Living Translation. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Oh, this is an awesome word to study and meditate upon for you this week, Faith Kids. God says that he's given us a gift. We know we love gifts, right? We all like to receive gifts. So he has given us a gift, and the gift that he's given us is his peace. He said when we're in trouble and we don't know what to do, he's given us his peace. So I want you to meditate upon that scripture this week, Faith Kids, and allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you on what God would have you to know about his word in this verse this week, God. I mean, Faith Kids. So, in our lesson on today, Faith Kids, we've been talking about when we're in trouble. We talked about how Jesus understands us, that he knows when we're in trouble, he understands, he has compassion, because why? He was here on earth and he went through things, trials and tribulations just like us. So he understood what we're going through. And then we talked about when we face troubles and issues and challenges, how Jesus protects us, how he is our shepherd. We are the sheep and he is our shepherd. And what does a shepherd do, Faith Kids? They protect us. They watch out for us. They make sure we have all that we need, that we're fed. And they even lay down their lives for us, just as Jesus has done for us, Faith Kids. So on today, we're going to talk about that when we've gone through these trials and we've gone through troubles, that we're supposed to help others. And that's what we're going to talk about on today, that no matter when we're going through things, it's not just for us. We're going through things, but when we come out, God wants us to help someone else. So we're going to turn in your Bibles to 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1. Just go over a couple more from John. 2 Corinthians. And we're going to chapter 1, and we're going to read verse 3 through 5 real quickly. Have a lot on today, as I say, but we're going to talk about what God wants us to do and how he wants us to help others. The word tells us that we're blessed to be a blessing. So we want to know what we're supposed to be doing. We want to do what God called us to do and do what he says that we are to do. So we want to know that he says he wants us to help others. So in our scripture on today, it says 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 3, All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is our merciful Father and the source of all comfort. Who comforts us? When we're not feeling good, or when we're in pain, or when we're feeling grief, who comforts us? God. He is our source of comfort. He comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort others. I know you heard that, Faith Kids. He says that he comforts us so that we can comfort others. So that means that's what we're supposed to do, because God has comforted us and he's given us hope. So then we take that same and we go and we help others. We comfort others. When they are troubled, we will be able to give them the same comfort that God has given us. For the more we suffer for Christ, the more God will shower us with the comfort through Christ. That's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to comfort others as God has comforted us. And you might be saying, okay, well, Sister Angela, how do I comfort someone? What does that really mean? It means you be a friend to them. When you was going through, did you think about maybe you having a problem with some homework assignments, and you ain't know what to do, how to find the answer? You was like, I wish I can call somebody. You know, mom and dad might not know how to help you. You're like, I wish I can call somebody to help me. A friend, right? So that's what we do. You reach out. Maybe you can be a good friend to someone else. Maybe they need help in their homework assignment. Maybe they don't understand the lesson or something. You can be that friend. You can comfort them in knowing, okay, I got this. I'm going to help you do this. I'm going to help you with this assignment. I'm going to help you read whatever it is. Because God has comforted us with that, right? He's given us the answer. So we can do that. You can be a friend to someone. You also, Faith Kids, we know that you can pray for them. You can pray with them and you can pray for them. That is how we give comfort to others. And then not only that, the best thing you know what you can do to comfort others is give them, share with them the Word of God. That's why we have these memory verses to keep in our memory, so that when we need them, when our friends, we need to help someone, we can rely upon God's word and share his word with them. That is how, Faith Kids, you can comfort others. Be a friend. Pray with them. Pray for them. And also give them the word of God. Share God's word with them. So let's turn over to another scripture, James chapter 1. And 27, remember, you can always come back. If I'm going fast with these scriptures, you can always, you know, come back and play it again and go over your scriptures. James chapter 1 and verse 27. So we're talking about what God has called us to do and how we are to help others. So in James 1 and 27, it says, pure and genuine religion in the sight of God the Father means caring for orphans and widows in their distress and refusing to let the world corrupt you. I know that said a lot. He's like, I don't know, widows, orphans, corrupt, I don't know what they mean. He is telling us that we're to take care of the orphans, those fatherless, the homeless. That's what he's saying. We're to take care of them. We're to help them. Remember, he's helping us. We're to help because we're blessed to be a blessing. So we're to look after the fatherless, the homeless, the widows, people who have lost maybe a spouse, you know, for whatever reason that they're lonely. That's who we're supposed to be helping. We're supposed to look out for them. And then he tells us, and while we're helping them and we're doing all this, we have to make sure that we don't get off the right path, though. We can't be corrupt. That means we're helping them. But we still stay focused, stay in what God has called us to do, stay in his word so that the world won't come and corrupt us, that we get sidetracked, that we're trying to help them, and then we get to be going off to the side. No, he doesn't want that. He says, stay focused, help them, but stay focused. So we're to help those who need help. Most especially, we know at this time, in Christmas time, the homeless, we need to help them. They need food. They need shelter. They need, you know, blankets, the little necessity, toiletries that we take advantage that we have readily every day, because mom and dad make sure you have all those things, right? So that's what he's telling us. We are to help those homeless, help the orphans, help the widows. In our next scripture, Romans chapter 15. Let's go there quickly, Faith Kids. Romans, Matthew, Luke, John, Acts, Romans. Chapter 15. And we're talking about what God has called us to do. That when, since He has helped us, He's brought us through times of trouble, whatever trouble is for you, whatever God has helped you come through, no matter what it is, how big or how small, He says, once you have been helped, we're to help someone else. So in chapter 15 of Romans, verse number 1, we who are strong must be considerate of those who are sensitive about things like this. We must not just please ourselves. Let me read that in the King James. It says, but we that are strong to bear the infirmities of the weak and not to please ourselves. So God's saying, because you've come through with His help, not that we did it on our own, because we can't. We've come through challenges and problems and situations, tests. Maybe it was a test you can't overcome. Whatever trouble to you in your life that God has helped you and brought you through, and because of your faith in Him, because that's who it is. We believe God, so we put our faith in Him that He helps us. So once we are strong in faith, then we are to gird up and help someone else who's weak. If you have a friend and you know that they in Christ, that they are a believer, and just for a second they just like, oh, I'm so tired, or I don't know what to do, and I'm just don't know. Then that, okay, so at that moment, you're strong and they're weak. So we're to help them. You're to encourage them. You're to give them the word or share or whatever God lays for you to help them, however He wants you to help them. But that's what it means. It says, when the strong shall bear the infirmities of the weak, you can share with them. You know, when I had this same situation and what God said to me was this, and what God told me to do was this, and that's how we bear the infirmities of the weak. We let them know they're not by themselves, that, you know, someone else has been through the same thing. We always think that I'm the only one going through this. No. But we let them know, okay, since God has brought me through, He'll bring you through. So that means the strong shall bear the infirmities of the weak. So we are to help those who are in trouble and don't know, or just, you know, sometimes they know, but we need to remind some, because you know how it is. You know, your parents say, clean up your room. But it's like, oh, I'm going to get to it. Oh, and then it's like the next day and you forgot. And when the parents come back, you be like, oh yeah, I knew to do that, but I forgot. Got sidetracked, right? You start doing other things. So that's what it is. It's not that we don't know, but sometimes we have to remember what God has promised us, what God has said to us. So that's when others can help us. Those who are like, okay, I've been through that. I know I can help you. We're bearing the infirmities of the weak. So that is how God wants us to help others, faith kids, to help them. When we go through difficult trials and tribulations and hard times and whatever it is, and God helps us, then He says that we are to help one another. So faith kids, I know that you are going to help others, whether you're praying for them, whether you're just being a good friend to them, whatever it is, sharing the word of God to them, helping the homeless. Maybe you know, we have Outreach Samaritan, feeding the homeless, going to help. Maybe you got your allowances that you want to donate and give, sowing a seed to help the homeless. Whatever it is, whatever way God is telling you that you're to help. We're to do that. It says we're to help one another. And when you know that you've been through and God has brought you through something, and someone is saying, and you're like, oh yeah, I know, I went through that. I felt the same way you were feeling. But guess what? You're going to help them by saying, this is what God told me to do. This is how God helped me to go through that. And then they can be encouraged, and then that builds up their faith, and they're able to say, yes, I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. So faith kids, we are to help one another. I know you have enjoyed this word on today like I have. We will see you next week. Remember, your memory verse. See you next week. Bye.